Hello everybody, welcome back to my educational blog, It is English Literature. I am Ardhendu De. Today, we are going to read Kafka's Metamorphosis. Here, we will try to understand the loneliness, frustration, and the oppressive guilt that has been expressed in the story through existentialism and surrealism. Kafka's work, like all the best literature, is multidimensional, can mean different things to different people, and as such, his metamorphosis is so rich that we can find many different meanings. Existentialisms and surrealisms, the realm of dreams and the unconscious mind, and all these things shape the very storyline of Metamorphosis. And it put forth the very loneliness, frustration, the oppressive guilt of an individual that is being threatened by the anonymous forces beyond his comprehension or control. It's a story of a modern man, but in a way, in a new look. A new look where one cannot be seen as in totality of the control of his own persona. But before we analyze the story, let's sum up the story in few lines. First of all, Gregor Samsa's family consists of a mother, father, and a younger sister. His father being older, Gregor functions as the main source of income for the family. He has a fairly good job, and so his family is still able to live fairly well financially. There is no problem. So the Gregor is the central topic or central character in this story. It happens in one day that Gregor wakes up to find that he is a bug, some type of beetle or so. As the book goes on, he was more and more troubled, grappling with his identity and associates more and more with a bug identity. It should also be noted that this whole time, the family has been dehumanizing him progressively more and more and trying to figure out what to do with him. And for the time being, just keeping him locked in his room. After some filthy process, Gregor dies. The book ends with the family happy with Gregor's death. As he feels as though a weight has been lifted off their shoulders. Some days or weeks later, they decide to take a hike in the mountains and talk about the marriage prospects of the sister, pretty much forgetting about Gregor's entirely. So, the story in a nutshell is a person whose memory was livid, is lost and erased. Life like that of a story written with the ink of water. Kafka's Metamorphosis is essential to understand some of the existential ideas and beliefs that influenced Kafka's thoughts and writings. It asserts that destiny is chosen and that the greater truth cannot be rationally determined. Self-sufficiency or independence from other people is another ideal that existentialism extols. The philosophy, it simply thinks that the individualisms and the self-determination will lead to personal anxiety, in fact. This can often lead to the kind of isolation and despair that Gregor experiences in this story. Now, who the Gregor is? Is he everyman? Is he a hero? It is better to tell that Gregor is a type of an anti-hero who faces a choice about whether or not to continue upholding the existentialist ideal. Simply, when you love someone, you commit ourselves to them. If they exchange a little bit, we accept that. Over time, they can change so much that if we met them for the first time, we would find them abhorrent. But we don't, because we are emotionally committed to them. That is the point. So, Kafka takes this tendency to accept changes in loved ones to the extreme. And by presenting us with an extreme case, someone overnight became a monster, verminous creature, he forces us to confront this tendency. Why do we continue to love people who change in ways we are not comfortable with? Is this not an existentialistic question? The way we see metamorphosis is that Kafka wants to portray the dehumanization that can happen after a horrendous freak emotional tug of war. It can happen in the case of love, crime, betrayal. Now, who the Gregor is or what kind of emotions Gregor passes through or the condition of Gregor, simply you can say that the way that Gregor loses his ability to speak and become horribly disfigured, the potential coma and bodily damage, suppose it can happen in a car accident, love betrayal, murder of someone, or even suicide. Kafka in fact portrays how vital and fragile empathy is, as in the case of Gregor. Metamorphosis indifferently reports the events following businessman Gregor Samsa's inexplicable metamorphosis into a gigantic insect, with a precise eye for the mundane details of the Gregor's life. This detached mood makes Gregor's transformation seem even more bizarre and unsettling. You might think that the main meaning of this story is to form social or socio-familial affairs, where the people treat others due to appearance, wealthiness or healthiness, age, gender, beauty or such like things. Now, how the human being is capable to love someone else unconditionally, even if the treatment is not corresponded? How the human nature can get rid of people that is not useful anymore for their own interest? So these existentialistic questions and the condition of the Gregor is like that of a surrealistic, dreamy one. So blending reality with the fantasy, tinged with ironic humor, Gregor, the insurance agent, one day finds, when awakened, that he is no more a human, enormous insect. He is rejected by family. He is left to die alone. Isolation due to dehumanization from either ends. Gregor's transformation, new physical form, may seem they are the catalyst of this story. And through this way, Kafka delivers the main point. Gregor's relationship with the family, the choices he makes or does not make, the various symbols in the book, that are the very most important and most elementary one in understanding Kafka's works, particularly the metamorphosis. Now, as a reader, why we not ask that how can a person be changed into an insect? So Gregor's transformation, without asking how and why Gregor became a bug, is itself a recurrent existentialistic and surrealistic thing. We should not ask. Asking the realistic question is not essential in existentialism and in surrealism. So while analyzing the text, if we can find out the key features or the basic features of surrealism as well as existentialism. The universe is indifferent and often apparently hostile to humans. These are the basic elements of them. Human existence is unexplainable. Isolation, anxiety, despair are all the part of our human civilization or our life. People judge life according to individual experiences. Freedom of choices exists, but so do the consequences of one's actions. A person's own convictions, not external rules, determine truth. These are the key features of understanding this way. One person's own conviction is the ultimate understanding of one's truth. Kafka's metamorphosis is a parallel to Kafka's own life, if you can say. Gregor is Kafka. Gregor's father is Kafka's father. The sister and mother too are the parallels of Kafka's sisters and mother. Kafka was always at odds with his father, who thought Kafka to be weak. Taunted many a time, Kafka's sister always took his side, but later on, she too abandoned him. But it might be the reality of the Kafka at that time. So Gregor's metamorphosis is a way for Kafka to show himself as a loathsome creature who could never fit into his family or society. It is also quite interesting to see how he rarely thinks about his metamorphosis. His first thought was about missing his work, almost as if he always felt like an unwanted creature even before his transformation. So, understanding the metamorphosis is like that of understanding Kafka's work as well as Kafka's life. And it is all through possible by existential and surrealistic philosophy. So, if you have any questions regarding Kafka's metamorphosis, you can just pop up here and ask me questions. I will try my best to give you answers. So, like, share, comment, and obviously subscribe to my channel to stay tuned to this kind of posts and educational learning. Thank you.